Good evening and welcome everyone to the Berks Hometown Heroes Community Spotlight. We have an awesome show tonight. Tonight we're going to be showcasing the Exeter Township football boys team that is really doing a tremendous job this year. They're a truly magical season. They're in the second round of districts that we're going to talk about. We're going to talk about the magical season and talk about everything going on. We have a great array of players here, seniors, junior, and sophomores. So before we get started, I'm going to have all the players introduce themselves. If you want to give me your class and your position. We'll start with you.
Hi, my name is Alex Javier. I'm a senior. I'm a wide receiver and defensive back for the team.
Jalen Miller, defensive line, number 63. I'm a senior, class of 2020.
Robbie Unruh, number 62. I play defensive line and offensive line.
Sean Henry, senior, and I'm a kicker.
Gavin McCusker, junior quarterback.
Ty Yoakum, fullback, middle linebacker, sophomore.
Okay. You can keep the mic. We'll actually start with you guys. Pretty amazing season. You guys, of course, the furthest any Exeter team has ever gotten. I did confirm that today with Mr. Tom McGath, that this is the furthest that any Exeter team has gotten. What makes this team pretty special versus previous years that you guys have been on? And what's the magic this season that keep you guys having an awesome regular season and going this far into districts?
It's really just that we all believe in each other and that we think that we can do big things and we just want to keep going. We don't like to lose.
That's the quarterback.
honestly, the team chemistry this year has been like tremendous, and I've never felt anything like that between any other team that I've been on. So basically just like the bond that we have together and the will to win.
Let's always have to ask the kicker.
All right. I think that the team has great chemistry. Offense and defense are both focused in, and they've done a great job this year, and we've been able to pull everything together.
I think everyone's just playing for one another and focusing on doing their jobs, and everyone just wants to win for one another.
Yeah, like Ty and Robbie said, you know, we don't like to lose, and we all play as a team together. And like after the games, we always go out. We're always doing stuff together. Doesn't matter.
So there's really good chemistry.
Yeah.
What do you think about this
year? I say the same with them. The chemistry is really big. I think it's just a credit to what we did in the off season this year. We put in a lot of work the whole summer, so I think it showed that it's paying off.
Yeah. Let's talk a little bit about practice. What's a typical day in the life? When you guys start the season, prep for practice, July, August, and kind of just go through like a day in the life of a football player during practice and two-a-days and all that stuff.
We had like summer workouts, which was like 7 to 10 in the morning, 4 days a week. And then we went to 3 days or 2 days heat acclimation. Then to 3 days. And then once the season started, we practiced 4 days a week. And then obviously the game on Friday and then film on Sundays.
What do you guys talk about film a little bit? Like, what do you guys look at on film? The mistakes, the good things?
Yeah, we look at like what we did wrong and what we did good and how we can continue to get better. And we also look at the other team and see what their strengths and weaknesses are and see if we can attack that.
Got it. What do you guys think about the film and the practice schedule?
It was good.
Everybody, how it helps you guys?
Attention, focus. The coach really gives us good examples on what we did wrong and how we can fix it. And Alex?
I'd say it's definitely a very big part of our season, big part of our success, because every Sunday we're there for about 2 hours and we go over offense, defense, split it up, and everyone has like an individual assignment of what they can do better.
Right now, let's start with the regular season. You guys had a tough loss to Berks Catholic, which could have demoralized the season. So what did you guys do to kind of rally the troops? So you could start to rally the troops after that tough loss to Berks Catholic, how you guys really rebounded and, you know, just had two other losses, but they were both very close games. So then you guys dominated pretty much the rest of the season.
Yeah, we didn't want to be the team that would lose in big games and be the team to lose against teams like Berks Catholic. So we just want to go from there and keep winning.
So Jeff, what did you do as a... I'm sorry, that's your dad's name.
We knew that like one loss wasn't gonna define our season, and we knew that we just had to like let it go, move on to the next game, and win the next week.
We had to make sure that everybody was doing their job, whether they were a kicker or quarterback didn't matter. Making sure that what they're doing was correct, and if we were all doing what we're supposed to do, then we were able to pull out the big wins.
Got it.
I think there's been an expectation of success around here for a while, and we didn't want to be the team that stopped that. And, you know, we wanted to build on last year and keep improving and keep moving the program forward.
I think we realized after the loss that the game's not over till it's over. We got to keep playing through the whole thing. Feel me? At the second half, we celebrated, and they took advantage of that.
Got it. Alex?
Yeah, I think like Gavin said, we didn't let one game define us. We kind of turned it around and made the farthest run that Exeter's ever had so far. Looking to keep it going.
So then the regular season, you guys did very well. You won a lot of big games against some really quality opponents. Let's talk about just one more game. The Mifflin game was another tough game. Then we'll talk about the good stuff. But tell me about that game. You guys really, you know, I think that's a game that you guys could have won as well. And if you guys would have won that game, you would have won the division, right?
Yeah, Section 1 gotcha. Title.
Okay. Talk to me about that game. If you could just want to go through that game.
All right. It was an intense game the whole game. We were down by a lot at half, and we're able to pull it back the second half. Held Nick Singleton to under 20 yards. And then we pulled it back. We were almost able to score in the last drive. We would have ended up winning the game, but...
assuming you made your kick.
Yeah, I would have. But that just showed that we had a lot of chemistry and we were able to do what we were supposed to do.
And Mifflin's been the team, over the past couple years at least, they've been the team in that division to beat. So I think you guys showed that you guys could play with that team. So I think going forward, I think Exeter, thanks to you guys building the foundation, is it fair to say that you guys are right up there with them now over the next couple years?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
So talk to me about during the season, what do you guys, I know you guys talked about the chemistry that you guys have, but what do you guys do like outside of the football? Like what do you guys do together?
Every Thursday, besides this Thursday, because we're here right now, we're usually at a team dinner. We go out before every game, we go out to a team dinner, pick a new spot every night, and we're there for an hour and just talk and eat. And it's like a family, it's a family football team.
Great.
Mm-hmm. After the games, we usually have a party if we win, celebrate the win, and
well, we just always find ways to hang out with each other. We had a cookout this summer. You know, we were always just going to people's houses, hanging out, just enjoying each other.
Excellent. One of my favorite games was homecoming because I had the fireworks. So tell me about the homecoming game, the fireworks scoring after every touchdown. That was another close game. Weiser kind of surprised a little bit. They were winning the game, and I'm like, I want to light fireworks, so I need you guys to score a touchdown so I could have the fireworks go off. So tell me about that game and homecoming, fireworks, and the big win against Weiser. That was actually, you threw the pass at the end of the game. That was awesome, I think, to you?
Yeah,
perfect. Yeah. Tell me about that game. That was magical to me. That was just a great,
that was
great
really
atmosphere. We had a packed house, fireworks. It was just a fun atmosphere.
That was a really like exciting atmosphere, like you said. Like losing in the first quarter, or in the first half, and then coming back all the way from 14-7 at half, coming back and rallying together and showing that like we're a team to be beat in this division. But coming back and doing what we had to do was really exciting.
Yeah, tell me about the homecoming experience.
The homecoming game it was very intense. And the game, like when we went into half, it was, everyone was kind of had their heads low and realized that some people weren't doing their jobs right. And so then we all just realized what we were doing wrong and decided to fix them throughout the game, and then we pulled through at the end.
Can we talk about homecoming?
We knew going into it that it was one of the biggest games of the season for us during the regular season, and that it was a big revenge game. And we needed to pull off the win. And
revenge how? Because they beat you guys?
Beat us last year. Okay. Yeah. And like I said earlier, we played really well in the second half. We were able to pull it out.
Yep. Let's talk about the homecoming.
Yeah, we started really slow. But once Alex made the play at the end of the half to bring it within 7, we basically took the momentum and we didn't look back from there. We just kept going.
Yeah, we had our heads down first half, second half. That team chemistry started to click in. So we all rallied together as a family, and we got the win.
Good.
Alex? Yeah, definitely. Like Robbie said, after we took that momentum and we had it in the second half, and I feel like our defense kind of like works in like waves. We like lock up, and the whole second half, I just felt like we were playing together, and we were fundamentally sound. We didn't let up any big plays. So
yeah. It was good. Talk to me about some of the records you guys have? I know you have the, you want to tell the folks the record you have. And
yeah,
and
so I have the all-time receiving yards record and the all-time receiving yards or receiving touchdown record, and I'm one catch away from the all-time receptions record. Oh, wow. So.
And that'll count if you
if I get it the next game. So
great. I don't know if the playoffs count differently than the regular season.
I have the all-time passing record or yards and the all-time touchdown record.
And you've been a quarterback for, this is the second year at Exeter. Were you the quarterback last year?
No, this is my first year.
First year as quarterback, and then you're a senior next year.
Yes.
I know there was some competition at quarterback. Actually, you also play quarterback. So tell me about, was that a friendly competition about the quarterback situation?
Honestly, in the offseason, like, we kind of fed off each other. I think we both pushed each other, and it only benefited us in the long run.
Yeah. And then talk to me about some of you guys played together for a long time. I know you two played together. You want to tell me about when you guys started to play together as kids, and some of the other kids on the team you could give a shout out to.
Well, me and Ty have been playing together since we were, what, 7, 8 years old. So we've been playing ever since then, bonded
together.
What
did that start as? What age group was that?
That was like Mighty Mites, so like 7, 8.
So that was over.
Tackle football, yeah.
That's Donorsville, and then
yeah.
Played throughout the years.
Yep.
Any other players on the team that you kind of have a bond with from playing as a little kid?
J.R. Strauss, John Oberholzer, Josh Cupid, so a bunch of players.
Tell me about what was your favorite regular season moment? We'll go with each of you, then we'll get into the district scenario.
My favorite regular season moment was definitely Connor Weiser at the end when I picked it off at the end to seal the game.
I'd have to go with Ty with the Connor Weiser game, throwing that last ball to Javi, knowing that once he caught it, he was going to score. And once we knew that would happen, we were going to win.
My favorite moment was against Governor Mifflin, hitting a field goal to bring the score within one touchdown, and then knowing that I could possibly win on an extra point.
Yeah, my favorite was probably Weiser after the win, you know, just such a big win to get that. And I was just really pumped about it.
Definitely Weiser. I lead big hit on the quarterback to let Ty get the interception.
Great.
I'd say Weiser as well. It was a big momentum game and the last play and the play before half. So
you guys had a good enough record, obviously, to make the district playoffs. You guys came in as the 11 seed, which was, you know, pretty low. But you guys dominated William Penn, so let's talk about that game. You guys beat a 6 seed pretty easily. Tell me about that game.
I don't think we
on the road.
We didn't really see ourselves in 11 seed because we had 2 games that were within really close point or really close scores. So we knew going in there that we were confident that they weren't 5 seeds better than us. So we just played to our potential.
Gotcha. Tell me about the district game, first game.
We knew we could win, and that's simple. We knew we were going to come out with the W if we all practiced hard. If practice was all good, that was it.
Yeah, I think the coach came up with a really good game plan, and everyone executed it, and it came down to they just made more mistakes than we did, and we played clean football.
Going into it, we were seen as the underdogs, and usually our team kind of feeds off that energy. And I think our defense played a really good game that game. Nick Schaefer was able to come up with a few big plays for us.
Like Sean said, like when we play with that chip on our shoulder, when you guys count us, when everyone counts us out, we know that we can make big things happen.
Yeah, our coach said that we want to be playing our best football in November, and I think we played our best football that night.
Yeah, then you beat Shippensburg, which is a 3 seed, so another really good team now. So now you're getting into the really quality teams, and you guys won a really close defensive struggle, it looked like. So let's go through that game and you know, what you guys, how you guys handled Shippensburg, how you prepared for that game, and how you guys pulled the win out there, too.
So our coach, defensive coordinator, Coach Ciotto, he pretty much watches film all the time, and he watched all 11 of their games, I think, a span of like 2 days. So he made a really good defensive
game. They were undefeated, Shippensburg.
They were undefeated, yeah, and he made a great defensive game plan. He put us in positions to get interceptions, to make tackles for loss, and we just did our job.
Let's go through the Shippensburg game.
We were losing at halftime. No, all of us didn't have our heads down, though. We came out, we knew that second half team chemistry was going to kick in, and we got the W once again.
Yeah, I mean, offensively, we didn't really produce like we usually do, but luckily the defense was able to clamp down, and we were able to do what we needed to do to pull it out.
Like I said earlier, we are a very good second half team, and we were able to keep them at 14. And luckily, I was able to hit a field goal with like 6 minutes left to give us the lead. And then Alex had an interception at the end of the game, which sealed it.
Like Robbie said, how like the offense didn't really score that many points. I can't thank the defense enough for coming out and playing so sturdy.
Yeah, coming out the half, some people weren't doing their jobs. And then we just regrouped again and then decided that we weren't going to let them score.
So let's talk about tomorrow's game versus Cedar Cliff. They're the 2 seed now, so now it's an even higher seeded team. But you guys, of course, proved that you could beat any team. So what's your mental state going into the game tomorrow? And what do you guys, have in terms of the preparation in that for that game?
I think we're very prepared. Our defensive coordinator, again, has done a really good job this week, and he's putting us in the right positions. We know who their best players are. We know what gaps we have to fill, and we're just ready to play football. We want to ride the momentum we have as long as we can.
Excellent.
I mean, for me, my mindset of going into it is to stop the running back. That's all I have to do. As a team, is to keep the same focus we always been in, and that's to keep on going.
Yeah, we trust in our coaches. They're going to put us in opportunities to succeed, so we just got to execute when we get there, and hopefully we can come out with a W.
This is another one of the games where it's a possible upset and a revenge game. Last year's game.
How's this a revenge game?
Last year they beat us first round of playoffs.
Oh, yeah. In districts?
56-7.
Yeah, so hopefully we're able to rebound off of that. Use that energy from last year. And
is the running back, is he back, the same kid?
Yep.
And what's so special about him? He just has a lot of yards.
I think he's like the all-time.
I think he's good up the middle is what I hear.
Yeah, he's very good at hitting his gap and getting a lot of yards after contact.
Gotcha.
A lot of carries. We're going to stop that.
Gotcha, carry. Okay, yeah. I agree.
Coming from the offensive side, I think that we're going to put a lot of points up tomorrow. And I think that since the way we've been studying their defense this week, I think that we have a good game plan then.
Got it.
I think that we're just going to keep playing like we've been playing. And like we go into every week thinking every team is Alabama or Clemson or someone, and that we just need to play
LSU
like we always do. Yeah, LSU.
Quick question for Gavin. I always want to ask a quarterback this. What's the game did you get beat up the most in terms of getting sacked a lot, and how sore were you the next day? Like, is there a game that you could barely move the next day?
I have to go with the Mifflin game.
Oh, really?
That was just a hard-fought battle the whole game.
And lots of hits and contacts.
Yeah, trying to come back the whole game, and so.
Tell me about how the school's been and the school spirit for you guys. I know football kind of gets all the publicity usually because it's usually the sport that draws the most attention. So how has the student body been towards you guys, and are they excited for tomorrow? Is there any pep rallies for tomorrow?
Yeah, gym. We actually have a fan bus coming out all the way to the game.
Yeah, shout out to Mr. Vecchio. He's being the chaperone and the chauffeur. I think he might be even driving the bus. So we'll see. All the students going to be
awesome.
Popping out to the game.
Yeah, what do you see in terms of the school spirit?
It's been great. I mean, to have people come out to Shippensburg, like 2 hours away in the freezing cold, it's just really special.
Yeah, I mean, tomorrow's even a closer drive, so you might even have a bigger Exeter crowd, hopefully, and the weather looks pretty good. So
Exeter's really good at traveling to all of our away games.
Great.
We usually always fill out the other bleachers. And they always will show like school spirit, so they'll all wear the same, like whether it's camo or whiteout, they'll all as one show out to the games and be a good support.
Yeah, shout out to all the fans and everyone who's coming out every week in and week out, especially the Blue Crew.
Yeah, there's been like a lot of people that have been coming to this, haven't missed a game all year. So shout out to those
people. And then let's give a shout out to the cheerleaders and the band. What do they mean to you guys that they're at every game, and the support that the cheerleaders and the band give you guys during home games and some away games?
We think it's awesome because they're there standing in the cold and really not. They're just cheering for us and give us support and motivation. So it's great.
The fact that they stand out there in the cold to cheer, I think I appreciate them.
Yeah, it's just great to have people in your corner that you know are always going to support you, and they're going to be there no matter what.
Yeah, having the band is out there is pretty cool because it really gives you that high school football vibe. Them being in the background, always playing, and the cheerleader is always showing support for the team.
Like Sean said, like with the cheerleaders and the band there, everyone just like get a feel for each other and you like push, like strive off of each other.
Yeah, the cheerleaders have been really supportive. They get there like an hour before the game, even if it's 30 degrees. Like last week.
It was cold.
All right, let's talk to the seniors a little bit. Two questions for each of you. What are you going to do post-high school, and what's your favorite memory from your Exeter years?
I'll start with my memory. My favorite memory was probably last year, my junior season, playing against Springford, and I was able to hit a 41-yard field goal to send it into overtime with like 30 seconds left. So I'd say that's probably my favorite memory. And then post-high school, hoping to go to college for football. I've been accepted into a few places, so hopefully I can get my name out there more.
Awesome. And, congratulations.
Yeah, play for them. Thank you.
For the future, I plan on attending a four-year university, majoring in biochemistry. And I'd say my favorite memory has probably been, just this season. And
it could be the show, too, you could say.
Just this playoff run in this season, the team chemistry has been amazing. It's just great to go out there and make memories with your brothers.
I think my favorite memory is just coming up here in general. The whole Exeter experience has opened my mind to more things I've never seen before.
Where were you from prior?
I was at Upper Marion.
Okay.
Down in KOP.
Gotcha.
So, and I plan on attending a four-year college and majoring in sports medicine.
What about you?
Honestly, my favorite memory has to be being Wiser for that homecoming game. That was a pretty special moment, and that was a great game for us. Future plans, I plan on attending a four-year college and playing football or basketball. And
have you been looked at for?
Yeah, some Ivy League schools.
Schools. So what's the point of you at with the college? You guys have some offers out there already for you? Or you guys are still searching around?
I have one, Misericordia.
Oh, good.
Up in Northern PA.
Up by Scranton.
Yep. And then I've been accepted to four schools so far.
Wow.
So hopefully I'll have another offer come my way.
Excellent. Let's talk to you then. You're going to be the senior next year, so you're going to be more of the leader that you are now as the quarterback, obviously, but you'll even have a bigger role as a senior plus the quarterback. So tell me, I know you're going to miss these guys, but tell me what your focus then next year is going to be to kind of keep the program going with the great success that you guys had this year and the previous couple years. So what's your mindset? I know you have a game tomorrow, but in the future, some of your goals next year?
Mindset for next year is just to keep the team chemistry going. I think like everyone bonded on the team this year, and the more that we can do that next year and keep this going it means most.
Gotcha. So Tyler, you're the youngest of the group here. This is a great learning for you, and would you want to help some of the underclassmen coming up next year? What's some of your short-term goals next year to help the team even be more successful?
Yeah, like Gavin said, just keep the team chemistry going. I just wanted, again, to be, like, our chemistry with, like, all these guys and have all the younger guys that are coming up to have that chemistry, too.
Gotcha. Let's talk about if you guys beat Cedar Cliff, then there's, what, two games left or one?
Well, that'll be the district final if you beat them.
And that'll be at Hershey?
Yeah.
And then if you win that game, you go on the states?
Mm-hmm.
And how does the state playoff system work? I guess there's probably less teams.
Well, technically right now, this is considered the first game of states for us because we have the largest district in Pennsylvania.
Gotcha.
So there's only 16 teams left in
the
entire state.
And then how did the district work? Because the record you guys had, you were ranked off of...
It's based off power ranking. So based on your strength of schedule and who you beat and how much you lose.
So you guys had to make it based off the teams that you beat, obviously, and then you guys were ranked higher. So you guys, even with the losses, had a higher ranked schedule probably than some of the other teams that may not have made it.
Yeah, that's correct.
Excellent. And then how's your parents? Are your parents excited for tomorrow?
I think they're very excited. They've been supportive the whole season. Shout out mom and dad, but probably watching right now. So.
Yeah.
Shout out mom. She's supporting me through everything, and she'll be there tomorrow.
Yeah, they've been there since day one, so I'm sure they'll be there tomorrow cheering me on, ready to go. Shout out to mom and dad.
Yeah, my mom, dad, and sister will be out there. I appreciate them for supporting me since I joined sophomore year, and they'll definitely be out there screaming my name, I'm sure.
Yeah, huge shout out to my mom and dad and Chase and Claire. I'm sure they'll be out there tomorrow.
Huge shout out to both my parents and Chase and Kyle. My parents and Chase will always be there, and Chase will be on the sidelines helping coach.
Great.
And I know Kyle will be watching if he can.
And a question for you. What does a kicker do at practice? Is one of the questions someone asked me to ask you.
Yeah. Well, sometimes we'll start out with like special teams, and then if we move into offense, we'll sometimes do extra points during offensive team when they drive up and down the field. And then in our spare time, we just focus on critiquing things that we might have done wrong the week before. Okay. Or just sometimes we'll be in the weight room trying to get stronger.
Excellent. Well, thank you guys for the great season. Again, for those that are watching that may not know, this team here has gone further than any other Exeter team. They've beaten two teams already in districts. First win was against William Penn in York, and then the second win was against Shippensburg. Tomorrow they play at Cedar Cliff, and that's at Camp Hill. Yep. Camp Hill, so you can definitely get online. And is it going to be streamed tomorrow? Or is it going to be just...
I don't think so.
You have to be there, not on TV. Okay, so for those that can't make it, I'm sure there'll be some internet site that has the scores, Reading Eagle, and that. So I want to wish you guys luck, and any other last second words? We'll start with you for tomorrow. If you want to give a prediction or just don't jinx it, whatever you want to do before we say goodbye.
I think we're pretty confident. I think everyone's been doing their jobs all week, so we're really excited to go out there and play.
I got something special to show y'all tomorrow. Shout out to Coach Bauer and all the rest of the coaching staff.
Yeah, I think if we just keep playing the way we're playing and, keep pulling for one another, I think we're going to come out on top.
Yeah, going off of what Alex said, if we do our individual jobs, I think we'll definitely be able to get that chemistry going and pull out the win.
I think the offense is going to come out and produce tomorrow. Shout out to Coach Gibbons.
I just think we need to play how we normally play and just show that we can beat another LSU.
Yes, and I want to thank your coach for allowing you guys to come. Great working with him. And I want to give a shout out to Mr. Tom Lagathe, the athletic director at Exeter, does a great job. Great athletic director, and good luck tomorrow on behalf of the township and the school. The whole community is going to be cheering for you guys. So good luck, and let's win tomorrow.
Thank you.
Have a great night, everyone.